What's up, guys? It is Jack, back up in this bitch for 10 Litres Fitness. Exciting announcement today. I'm going to Cambridge to get my VO2 max tested. So I'm here at Norwich train station right now. I'm going to go meet my friend at Cambridge University. We're going to get this test done. And this is something I'm really excited about because, you know, this is not only a bodybuilding channel, but a fitness channel. So that entails a lot more than just trying to look good. And from what I understand about a VO2 max tester, I mean, he'll explain it a lot better than I can, but I know that it's one of the best indicators of all-round stamina and fitness. So getting this tested is something that'll bring a lot to the channel, I believe. So anyway, without further ado, let's go get these train tickets. So I'm on the platform right now, just waiting for my train to get here. It's pretty fucking dead right now. I don't know if you can see that, but there's no one around, but which is nice. So I just got some food from an outlet at the station back there, so I'll show you what I got in a minute, but for now, just waiting for the train to get here. Catch you guys soon. Okay guys, so here you can see I'm taking my VO2 max. Sorry to jump straight into it, but we were a bit pressed for time, so didn't really have the time to do any more vlogging up to this point. But yeah, so to get into this, you can see I've got this crazy Bane looking mask on my face, but believe me when I say this is no Bane mask, this is some very high-tech sports equipment. What this equipment does right here is it brothers even my most sensitive little breath, and it plots it on this computer screen you can see just behind me, okay, that Dwayne's looking at. And what that does is it essentially works out my VO2 max from that. Now my task was I had to keep the cycle going at a rate of 90 revolutions per minute, while the test was incremental, so that means that every minute it gets slightly more difficult for me to pedal, that is, so the resistance increases every minute. And if the rate of revolutions sits below 90 per minute, for more than 5 seconds the test is terminated, and I'm sure you're going to be able to see when that takes place by how flustered and tired looking I am at that point. It was really difficult at that point, it was getting tough on my quads.
You have VO2 max of 42.
42, is that right? Thank you very much.
Yeah, so you can see like it almost plateaus.
Oh really? So that's where I...
So that's your upper limit of your oxygen uptake.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so you can see there's a nice plateau there.
Well, that's interesting. What is up, guys? I'm back at my parents' place right now. Just got back in. Had a good time in Cambridge, you know. Got my VO2 max tested, as you saw. Got the result of 42. I'm going to talk a bit about that in a minute. But, you know, first of all, sorry I didn't vlog a little longer. But, you know, my camera is running a bit low on battery. Plus, you know, I just wanted to hang around with Dwayne a little bit, you know, because we haven't hung around in a little while. I didn't want to be filming the whole thing. It's a bit awkward. But, yeah, we got some food, had a Subway, and went shopping. Got this t-shirt I'm wearing right now. You see that? Jurassic World. I fucking love that film, man. yeah, to talk about the VO2 Max then. My test came out as 42 for my VO2 Max, but Dwayne did tell me after I did the test that the bike typically tends to underestimate it by about 10%, so my number could potentially be as high as 46, but which you can see if you look at these graphics, you know, I'm in the, you know, good fit to athletic fitness range, which is something I'm personally very proud of and happy about, because as I said at the start of this vlog, you know, this channel is not just about trying to look good, you know, it's also about, you know, in the name fitness, you know, I really wanted to do something that actually tested my fitness, you know, because VO2 Max is a really good, you know, indicator of overall fitness. And the reason I really wanted to do that is because I think fitness is really, it's kind of lost its way, you know, in today's society. A lot of people take fitness really just to mean looking good naked or, you know, looking good in a tank, look good for the beach. But really, it means so much more than that. And in a way, fitness and health are kind of one and the same thing, you know, they're very much intertwined and, like I say, connected. So being fit and healthy is a major part of fitness. And you see these stories of bodybuilders dropping dead and, you know, no disrespect to them, you know, rest in peace by all means, you know, I don't mean any offense, but, you know, if that's the case, you're dropping dead early, no matter how good you looked, you know, that's not fitness, you know, that's what separates bodybuilding from fitness. So, you know, doing this kind of thing, I want to kind of encourage fitness in more people, you know, actual, real fitness. And that's the point of me getting this test done, you know, kind of encouraging myself a lot at the same time as well, motivating myself to be fit and healthy, as well as just looking good. So, you know, like I say, I've got this test done, it came back with a result I'm really happy with, you know, a scientific result to say I'm fit and healthy, that's very nice, you know, something I enjoy hearing. And, yeah, so in addition to that, my plans are to go back 2 weeks later, do the same test again, and see if, you know, in the meantime, I can improve my VO2 Max. You can see over here, I've got, can you see I've got my exercise bike? I'm going to be spending a lot of time on the exercise bike over these next 2 weeks, guys. I'm going to try and rev that VO2 Max up, see if I can boost it by a couple of points, and I'll just see what I can do, you know, because that'll be interesting. It's not every day you get the opportunity to do something like this, visit a sports science lab, you know, we're always reading these studies in bodybuilding, you're trying to see what works, what doesn't, draw our own conclusion from them, but, you know, this is the place those studies are made. You know, the people I was talking to, these are the people who, you know, carry out these studies and really know their stuff. So it's nice to be on the other side of things, you know, where the studies are made rather than just reading them, and get, you know, the opinions of some real sports scientists on some issues like macros, protein intake, you know, what is and what isn't, what you've seen to work and what doesn't. You know, that was really interesting as well, talking to the sports science people. So that's something I really enjoyed, as well as, you know, you hear the, you know, bro science from the guys in the gym. So it's nice to get both sides of things and experience that well, because I've not done that before, and, you know, who knows if I'm going to do that again. So overall, yeah, great time, had a great day in Cambridge with Dwayne, you know, had fun doing my VO2 Max test. But anyway, guys, that's all from me today. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.